Hello and welcome to Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning and you join me in a hole in the ground. I'm currently sitting at the bottom of a deep hole in the ground in the middle of a lava flow in central Oregon. On the slopes of the Newberry Volcano is a couple of lava flows. This one's about 8,000 years old. And when this lava flow erupted in the northwest rift zone of the volcano 8,000 years ago, it flowed through a forest. This basaltic lava is really thin and runny, and it's able to preserve the shapes of the trees as it cools. So if I look up above me, you can see this nice circular hole, which used to be filled with a tree. Since lava flows at about 1,000 degrees Celsius, the tree usually catches on fire pretty quickly and it burns away or decomposes away over time, leaving this hole in the lava. This place is called the Lava Cast Forest because it has a lot of these lava casts. When the lava flowed around these trees, it created a mold of where the tree used to be. In some of these, you can even see bark imprints. However, in this hole that I'm sitting in, you can't see any of these bark imprints, and it's just raw, tough lava that's really sharp, and you can hurt yourself on it pretty easily. This particular tree mold is really cool because it's three different trees all interconnected. There's one in front of me, there's one directly above me, and behind me you can see a little bit of light. That's another tree that goes straight up to the surface. The sides of that one are really cool because it remelted at some point, and all of this rough basaltic texture melted away, and so now it's smooth and slick, and it looks really cool in the light. I'm in another lava mold here of a tree that was laying down when it got engulfed by lava. And here you can see some excellent secondary melting features. All these drips and lava sickles. And a lot of spider webs. This has been Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning. Thank you for joining me.